Hello, my name is Tom Schenk, Chief Data Officer for the City of Chicago, and I'm going to show you OpenGrid, a free website that uses open data to explore Chicago and your neighborhood. In the next few minutes, we're going to show you how to perform some of the basic functionality so you can search Chicago. To get to OpenGrid, use your browser on a desktop or mobile device and visit chicago.opengrid.io. First, let's take a look at the quick search functionality, where you can quickly find information. Visit the quick search box, where you can search for places and data. For instance, type Wrigley Building to zoom into that building and surrounding area. You can also type an address. For best results, use the full address including zip code, such as 50 West Washington Street, Chicago, Illinois, 60602, which is the location of the Daily Center Plaza. You can also use it to find some basic data. For instance, to find all business licenses in the 60602 zip code, type business underscore licenses 60602. You can use the tooltip to see the type of queries you can perform in this quick search box. To look at the names of other datasets you can search, take a look at the datasets listed under the Advanced Search button. OpenGrid does its best when you use the Advanced Search. To start, let's clear the map data by clicking on Clear Data. Press the Advanced Search button to bring up a new pane. First, we can get started by looking at the common queries, which are some basic queries to get you started. For instance, we can look at all of the street closures in Chicago. Click on the Common Queries menu and select Street Closures. We can look at that data and what this query provides us by clicking on Datasets and Standard Filters. We see that it gives us Transportation Department permits with a work type of ST closure. To actually see this data, click on the Submit button. OpenData will retrieve the data and display it on the map. Currently, OpenGrid will display 1,000 results at the map at any given time. Once the points are displayed on the map, we can click on the point to see more details about each street closure. You can navigate the map as you would any other mapping website. You can press on the Home button to recenter the map to the middle of the city. While you can click on points of the map, you can also use the grid to look at more details. Click on the gray bar at the bottom of the screen. Here, you'll see some details for each result. Suppose you want to look at the street closures filed by NBC, perhaps getting the hope to look at the next Chicago PD episode. Simply type NBC to look at all the results, including that word. You can click on a row to see more information that's displayed on the map. From here, you can also explore the heat map of where these closures are across the city. Click on the heat map icon and we'll create a thermal heat map. We get to see the heat map results and the corresponding points. We can remove the points by clicking on the layers icon and unselecting Transportation Department permits data to just leave the heat map. We can also remove the heat map using the same method. And now we'll add both of those back. But suppose we want to look at a lot of data at once. Suppose we want to avoid restaurants that have failed an inspection and has a lot of sanitation complaints around them. For instance, we would want to look at food inspections, complaints about rodents, and 311 calls for sanitation complaints, that is garbage complaints. Let's start again by clicking Clear Data. Now, using the Advanced Search pane, we add datasets under the Datasets and Standard Filters menu. Selecting Food Inspections, selecting 311 Calls for Sanitation Complaints, and selecting 311 Rodent Complaints. For food inspections, we can add additional filters to only look for failed food inspections. First, let's only look for restaurants. To do that, click on Facility Type and type Restaurant. Then, we can look for failed food inspections, so we add another search criteria for failed results. We want to use different colors for each result. We'll use violet for food inspections and orange for rodent complaints. Click Submit to see the results on the map. Like before, we can either explore the data on a map or look at the grid. This time, the grid will show multiple tabs for each data set. If you want to export any of this data, click on the Export button, which will allow you to export in CSV, Excel, or PDF. While the citywide results are interesting, let's take a look downtown where most restaurants are located. Click on the additional geospatial filters in the Advanced Search pane to look for some more options. If we want to look at restaurants within 60602, click on Zip Code, which lets you choose zip codes from within Chicago. Then click on Submit to update the query. But suppose you want to look at your own defined area. OpenGrid allows you to draw on the map to choose a custom location. Let's return back to the Advanced Search pane, where in the same menu we can select Drawn Extents. Then use the tool on the left-hand side to select the drawing tools. And then we can draw on the area to look at the data. We have a couple of different options when using the Drawn Extent. We've used the Rectangle tool, and we've also used the Custom Polygon tool, so we can draw more complex shapes. You can draw as many polygons on the map as you'd wish. And you may have also noticed that we've drawn two distinct regions. As soon as we submit the query, data is only going to appear in the regions that we've drawn. And if you're on a mobile device, you can use your finger to complete these same operations. And finally, we can search around your device or around a marker that you place on a map. Returning to the Advanced Search pane, we can search around the marker and then choose the radius that we want to search around. In this case, we'll search 1 mile around a marker. On the left-hand side, we can then pick up a marker and place it on the map, and in this case, in the River North neighborhood. We return to the Advanced Search pane, and we click on the Submit button, which is going to resubmit the query, but now only looking within a mile radius of the marker we just placed on a map. These steps will help you use OpenGrid to answer your questions about your neighborhood and Chicago. I hope you found this tutorial to be useful. If you have any questions, please visit opengrid.io to find ways of contacting us. Thank you.